Hello everyone and welcome to today's class. Today we are going to talk about this subject, the subject of typecasting. Typecasting, or sometimes it's referred to as just casting, it means that you convert between different variable types. So it can be from a float to an int, or from an int to a float, from a char to an int, or between different types of structures. I'm gonna start by showing you an example so you can see what I am talking about. Let's start by creating a standard C application with standard IO and a main function. Today I'm using the text editor VI, but you can use Nano or VS Code or whatever you usually do. Okay, so let's create three different variables. The first is an int called a, and then I will have a float. So let's do let's do two floats. So B and Q. Q for quota. So A equals 15. And B equals 2. And Q equals A divided by B. So it's 15 divided by 2, which will be stored in a float variable. And let's print the result of this calculation. The correct answer should be 7.5. Let's see what we get. So let's do like this. No, not D. It should be F for a float. And then we will show the Q variable. It just returns 0 like this. Okay, so I will rename this a.c and compile. And the result is 7.5. So what is happening here is something that is called implicit type casting. And that is done by the compiler automatically. So the compiler will take these variables and make this A variable a float implicitly. If we were to specify this explicitly, that's typecasting that we control as a programmer, then we would do like this. Before this A variable, which is an int, we will just put a parenthesis and put float in there. So the type of the variable. This means that during this calculation, this int variable A will be temporarily converted to a float variable, and then the result will be stored as usual in Q. So let's save this one and rename, compile, and we get the same result. So this is the difference between explicit and implicit typecasting. So when do we use one over the other? Well, as long as no piece of information is lost during the calculation, the compiler can handle it as an implicit typecast. But if information might get lost during the transformation, then the compiler will give a warning or an error, and you will have to do an explicit typecasting like this. So basically, when you do this, you are telling the compiler, okay, I know the risks, and I take responsibility for it. So let's do an example where we might lose some information. What if we were to make all three an int? Let's test that. So Q will be equal to A divided by B. And I will use %F here again, just to see the same type of output. I will put Q in there. Return 0, like this. And if you wonder why I name it A and rename it, that's an old habit of mine when I'm using VI, so it doesn't recognize that I'm using a .c file. Because in some versions of VI, it behaves like Vim does and add colors and indentations and stuff like that. And I'm not really fond of that. So this is probably not necessary anymore, but I still do it out of habit. Okay. So this time we get the result 0. And that is probably because we did %F here. Let's try it once again with D for an int. Oh, sorry, I forgot the MB. Okay, now we get 7. So this time we lost information, because we didn't get 7.5, we got 7. So it didn't even try to round up the result. It just removed all the decimal numbers. So that is an example of losing information. Another example is when the types of variables are in different size. As you might know, the different types of variables in C use up different amounts of memory. So a char, for instance, is 8 bits. So a string of 8 zeros and ones. And then we have, at the other end, we have something that it's called long int, which is I believe 64-bit. And then, in addition to that, almost every other variable type. For example, int and float and double. All are 32 bits. So this one, the char, gives us 256 different combinations. So a char variable can have 256 different values, 0 to 255. And the int and the likes, they go from 0 to, if it's an I need to mention that as well. There are unsigned and signed int, and that means the minus sign. So signed handles negative numbers. So if it's a signed int, then it goes from about 2 billion, minus 2 billion, to plus 2 billion. And if it's unsigned, so it only handles positive numbers, then it goes from 0 to about 4.3 billion. And that's because of the different combinations when you have 32 zeros and ones. Okay, so that was a little theory lesson. Let's create a char called A and an int called B. And we let A be equal to 100. You can put characters like an A or a B or an at sign in a char, but you can also put the numeric value, anything from 0 to 255. And let's set B equal to A, and then we print out the numeric value of B, which is int, so let's move, let's compile, and let's run. It's equal to 100. So in this case, the compiler does an implicit typecast, because this is smaller than this. So no information is lost. And even if we were to reverse this, so we set B to 100. Oh. And A equals to B. So we reverse this. And then we print out the value of the char. We get the same result, because we are still in the range of the char, so no information is lost. But if we take a bigger number, like 300. That won't fit inside of this char because it only goes to 255. What happens now? Now we get the result 44. And we didn't get any warnings. That probably has to do with the configuration of the compiler, because I believe it should warn or even give an error in this case, because it tries a typecasting silently and it doesn't work as intended, because we want it to be 300, not 44. And this can be quite dangerous. Let's say you are coding an encryption software and a bug like this gets in the code and it's silently passed through and might crash the entire encryption or make it possible to hack it. So in this case, I would say you should all, if this is what you want it to be going to 44, then you should most definitely do a typecasting. Should do int right here. Because then it shows that when you look at the code, then it shows that this is what you intend it to do. And you should try to configure your compiler. Perhaps, let's see if I remove this and I were to add a flag right here. Dash wall. No. Okay. Until the next lesson, I will try to find out how you configure your compiler so it behaves as I believe it should, and warn for implicit typecasting in this case. But if you get an error or a warning when you are coding and converting between types, then just add the variable type like this before the ones that you temporarily want to convert. So what have you learned today? You have learned how to use implicit typecasting and explicit typecasting, and how it works and how it should work, and that you always need to be careful and know what you're doing, especially if you code like a server software or something like that. If you want more videos like this, please like and subscribe. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching and thanks for today.